and check your pan. So what they're doing here is checking the pan to make certain there's no live embers in there. Just about to pour gunpowder into a chamber, and so you want to make certain there's no sparks there from the last time you fired it. Lay hold of your fine powder and charge your pan. So we're now using our fine grain powder. Down the barrel is a slightly coarser powder, so we're charging our pan to the side of the musket. And close your pan. Cast off your loose powders and blow off your loose powder. Cast back your piece. So what we're doing there is getting rid of any loose gunpowder. We don't want that causing a problem later on. And this is it where I pause slightly. There is a, on the pan of this particular musket, it's a little bit loose and Musketeers, so just on part of the powder. So, we've now laid hold of your charge and charge your piece with powder. You'll notice most of the Musketeers are using the wooden bottles. Each one of the little wooden bottles holds one charge, one shot. One of the Musketeers actually used his powder flask again with a measured charge. So we then charge our piece with powder, ball and wadding. So we're using lead musket balls. They go down the barrel and the wadding is there to stop the musket ball rolling out and also try and close the charge so it makes it more accurate. Lay hold of your scouring stick. Withdraw your scouring stick. Shorten and reverse your scouring stick and ram home your charge. Now we get to the important bit, withdraw your scouring stick, shorten and reverse your scouring stick and replace your scouring stick. We need the scouring stick for the next shot, so we don't want to lose that. So it is an important piece. Recover your piece to the port position. So we now have loaded weapons. Blow upon your coals. So we're blowing upon the match, makes sense, it's nice and hot. Now at this point, I'm going to ask the Musketeers to turn through 90 degrees and actually face down the field. So not actually firing towards yourself. So to your left hand face and advance forward into a line. Lay hold of your match, pop and try your match. So we're now trying the match to make certain it will actually fire, making certain it's in the right place. Cover your pan. Blow upon your match. Present your piece. Now this is the bit where we hope the rain doesn't spoil it going off. Open your pan and give fire. Right, recover your musket. Now of course, during an actual battle, that's quite labor intensive. It takes a long time. Depending which